Tracy, love. You're going to have to trust me on this, okay? You are better off at school than you would be at home.
But it's not my home. I feel like I'm being punished for something.
No, Pilar. You have never done anything wrong.
Of course not. Why, Mama? Why, are you ashamed of me?
No.
Am I some sort of disappointment to you?
No, of course not. Don't ever say that. You're my precious, precious girl. I'm so proud to see this woman that you have become. It's everything that I have ever dreamed of for you since you were a baby.
I know you love me, Mama. And I know you think you're doing what's best for me. But I'm a grown woman now. I have my own dream. And I know how I want to live my life.
I've never heard you speak like this, Pilar. Somebody is feeding you ideas in your head.
I have my own ideas, Mama. Don't you know that? It's about time you start to realize that and accept me for who I am. I'm not going back to school, and that's final.
I'm moving out, that's all.
Yeah. He's made his decision. It's about time.
Okay, and that's all that's going on?
That's all it is?
Yeah, that's definitely all it is.
Is there a problem? I mean, you guys seem to have gotten along great before.
No. Everything's fine, right?
No, everything's not fine. Are you kidding me, Michelle? I mean, you're not bothered by the fact that Jesse and I have been living together this whole time?
Well, you don't exactly live together. You're just sharing the same space.
Get off it, Michelle. You know how I feel about him. You know I love him. Okay, and yet here we are, sleeping together, practically together, this whole time, alone, and you're okay with that?
Look, I know how Jesse feels about me, okay?
Oh, yeah, you do. You never had to worry about anything, huh? You never will.
Drew, come on. I didn't mean it like that.
Yes, you did, Michelle. He's a one-woman man. He is completely devoted to you. Besides, you guys got this whole Romeo and Juliet thing going on, right? I mean, only... let's not forget this is going to be a happy ending, right?
You just pick it easy.
No, let's just all get real here. We shouldn't live together. Right? We both know that, but why don't you just prove your devotion and your love to Michelle, and why don't you two just move in together? You can live at the Bowers, you can have your sweet little love.
I'm not moving into the Bowers house, okay? That's not what I want.
Well, I don't really care what you want anymore.
Is that true?
Yeah.
You said you didn't want to live with me.
Trying to get a rise out of me. You know how she gets.
Yeah, I know how she gets. But you just said that you didn't want to live with me.
I mean, I don't want to move into your family's house. I mean, for starters, Rick wouldn't want me there.
Actually, he's fine with it.
You already asked him if I could move in?
Yeah, he said he wouldn't interfere.
Doesn't sound like much of an invitation, Michelle.
Jesse, my brother wants whatever's going to make me happy, and that's why I came here, because I want us back where we were.
That's what I've always wanted.
Well, that's what I thought, but I'm not so sure now.
And what's that supposed to mean?
Walked in on something. I mean, is there anything going on with you and Drew?
No, I mean, Drew is just getting all worked up about getting me kicked out of this apartment. That's it.
Wait, I thought you wanted to move out of the apartment.
Well, I do. It's just, we were just arguing about my leaving.
Fighting that I heard down the hall sounded like two people who were a lot more than friends.
Oh, come on. That's ridiculous. I mean, where would you get that idea? You're wrong.
Am I? Jesse. Come on, if you have feelings for Drew, says anything, please.